Hello all, welcome back to CSK Technologies. In the previous videos, we have seen how to make every individual component like crane hook, hook anchor and bush for the crane hook assembly. We have also understood how the section view of an assembly can be understood with respect to the bill of material table. Now in this video, we'll be working on how to make a support plate as well as the end bush. Since both are working under part design workbench, I'd like to start with that workbench and start with making a sketch. Now, I know how to make a triangle, so I'd like to do that first. And I'd like to maintain symmetry. I'd like to give the rounds as well before further proceeding. We have our 18 rounds in between these two, so I'd like to give that. This is supposed to be 18. The length from here to here is supposed to be 50. This is the 50 which I've taken, so I can give the hole later in a very easy manner without complicating things. This is 18 again. This is 18 again. The angle between these two as per the triangle is supposed to be 60. So let me check that once. This is supposed to be 60. Now I can give intersection lines if I want to, so I can coincide it exactly at the center. So these two, this is the first intersection line I have. This is the second intersection line I have. This center should be coincided there, so I can use an intersection point in between these two and coincide that point at the location whatever we need. We need to coincide this on the horizontal, so I'm coinciding it. This is your rectangle. Now if you do not want to give any of these dimensions, you need not. You can directly give the overall length as well, which is actually supposed to be 115. Now the distance between this center and this center is also given. If you want, you can do that as well. If you do not want to complicate things this way, you can give the center to center distance in between these two as 76 as well. This is an easier way of doing it rather than complicating it. You can follow this procedure. So once I exit, I can add material and give it up to 7 mm. You can see the 7. Now you have to give the holes, as you can see. So the first one we can give either these ones, or you can give the center hole, whichever is flexible for you. So I'd like to give these ones first and make a sketch first. We have already maintained concentricity and we have already maintained 76 as the dimension. So all I have to do is take these as my references and maintain concentricity while I'm placing my point. Whenever I'm placing my point, you can see the icon which says concentric. You can do so. You can see the concentricity icon. Again, as I'll show it to you, you can see the concentricity icon. Now it says 15 dia, which is into 3. So I'd just like to select the point. It directly drills the hole. 15 up to the next. You can position, but it's since it's already. Let me try to position the sketch. It did not select the point. Again, once I say exit, it drills the hole at that location. You can use user pattern to repeat the same one multiple times wherever you have a point. Now, we already have maintained 50, but 38 is not maintained. We already know that it is at the center, so we can take the hole directly at the center, or you can directly give, you can give dimensions as well. For instance, 50 is exactly at the center, which we have already taken while making the initial sketch only. Now we need the dimension from this center. So we can take a reference point exactly at the center of this, maintain concentricity and maintain the 38 dimension, which is already given to you in the sketch. This is supposed to be 38. We know it's the center, but since 38 is there, I have given 38. The diameter is 25. You can give 25 and you can say up to the next and say. Now, there are six three-diametrical holes, which is on the PCD of 62, 52. So when I try to take a hole, I can go back to my sketch and start making the circle in a construction format. Now these should be coincided exactly at the center. So let me try to give the dimension, which is supposed to be 52, and then coincide it exactly on the center location. Coincident, again, this center should be coincident on this. Now this should be exactly on the circle, since it's a PCD, and I'm trying to make this feature, so I'd like to coincide it over here. I'd like to coincide this point on this face. Now once I exit, it'll ask me for the dimension. The dimension is supposed to be 6 and through, so I've just given up to next. To repeat this again, you can use a circular pattern if you want. You have an instance, you require complete crown, you need 3 of them with respect to the center. You can see that it creates 3, and then if you say OK, it creates these 3 corners. This is how you make a support plate for your crane hook assembly. Now let's save this file as support plate. Let's continue making the end bush. Now as you can see the end bush, we know that it's a diametrical component. So you can either use your pad or you can use your shaft, whichever is flexible for you. For me, shaft is very flexible, so I'd like to use the shaft. And I can directly make a sketch this way and then provide it with any axis. You can give the axis first as well, no issues. Now when I'm trying to give it, I know the diametrical dimension for this is actually 62. And the diametrical dimension for this is actually 25. Now we already know the lengths and the distances as well. So this is supposed to be 5 and this is supposed to be 7. Once I say exit, it tries to create a shaft, as you can see. Now there is 3 holes, as you can see, which we have done in your support plates. It's similar to that. So let's try to drill those holes. First, understanding how to do that. We know the center, so we can directly take the center, or we can give it later as well. Now when if I want to give it, we maintain concentricity, I can maintain concentricity. Then give the diameter for this, which is supposed to be 52 as mentioned in the drawing. This is supposed to be exactly at this location, which is on the center. I'm trying to make this feature. This is located on the PCD. Now it's of 6 dia, so I'll give 6 dia and then up to the next. We need 3 of them, so as usual, like we have done the last time, we can directly select it. Select the complete crown. We need 3 of them with respect to the feature and then give OK. There's also a hole exactly in the center which says 16 through, so you can do that as well. Select the center. As usual, let's try to maintain concentricity because it has a common center. And give 16. After that. Now the overall diameter is 62 as well. This is your end bush.